I'm, like you said, from the class of 1986. I'm 45 years old. I'll be 46 in May. They say black don't crack, so I just got to say that. I went to Thorpe, and I also went to Taft, which I graduated from as well. My son goes to Taft. My daughter comes here, which is awesome because my kids go to school where I went to school. I'm also running for local school council, so tell your parents to vote. So that's pretty much it. I work for General Electric. Anybody heard of General Electric? Maybe you guys have like a General Electric stove or appliance. General Electric's huge in appliances. And they also make engine for airplanes. So when you fly on a plane, you probably got a GE engine in the airplane that you're in. But so I've been with GE now 3 years, almost three. And prior to that, I worked for a company called Brook Electric for 20 years. And I deal with architects and engineers. I build schools, hotels. I did the Speed Coaster at Great America. I also did the Joker, if you guys heard of that ride, and you wrote it. But so I do a lot of design and new things. So when you drive past your Panera or your McDonald's, I used to build a McDonald's every, you said we build a McDonald's every 15 minutes. So I used to do McDonald's and Walgreens. But obviously, Walgreens and McDonald's are cutting back their businesses. So, but yeah, that's pretty much in a nutshell, somewhat where I'm at. I've traveled the world. I grew up on the west side of Chicago. I've been shot before. I got shot in front of my house. I've been through a whole lot of drama. And you guys are at this stage where you are going to go in probably in eighth grade, right? Eighth graders? So you're gonna go to high school. And life changes. People change. People that are friends are no longer friends. People that weren't friends are now friends. And then you add people along the way, or you may even have friends that will be with you the rest of your life. So I grew up on the West Side. I grew up Muslim. I was a Muslim for 21 years. I was born a Muslim. About 23 years ago, I accepted Jesus. So now I'm a Christian. And when I accepted Jesus, I was in prison. So there you go. But God can change you. And he changed me, and he changed my family. My family is not Muslim anymore, but now they're Christian. But the great thing about it is that my life has changed, and God does great things with people. And so he can take a broken toy. If you feel like you're a broken toy, he can take the broken toy and make it perfect. And so now I work for one of the top companies in the world. They're in the top 50, if you look them up. It's General Electric. And again, that's what kind of where I'm at. So I live in Mount Clair, which is not too far from here. It's like Belmont and Park is kind of the drag where we live. And then prior to that, I lived in Jefferson Park, which is just at Montrose and Central. So I speak Spanish and Romanian, so if there's any Spanish or Romanian people here, we can talk about that. I go to Chicago Tabernacle Church, which is at Cicero and Belmont. My company allots us a company car, so every 2 years we have a new car. So this is my second car, so I just got a new car, kind of like for Christmas. Once you put 50,000 miles, they give you a new car. So they encourage you to drive it as much as possible. And I call on all of the contractors in the city of Chicago. So I'm different, obviously. I got dreadlocks and earrings and bow ties, and it's a challenge, but that's who I am. And I don't let anyone restrict who I am. If they don't want to buy from me, they don't have to. I don't force anybody to buy from me, but I do a good job, and so that's why they should. So that's it. That's what I got. I got a son named Ty, a daughter named Avea, and my wife is named Tiffany. My wife's from Puerto Rico. So that's it. Any questions? Yes.
What was your favorite thing about Thorpe?
Thorpe, I had some really great teachers. You know, they were, they cared. They believed in me and helped me along the way. So if you have challenges, always ask for help, because there are people and teachers that care. Anyone else?
What sports do they have?
What
sports do they have?
We played in this, is this, well, there was no swings or anything out here, and it wasn't even a parking lot. We used to play, we weren't allowed bats, so we would throw the ball. So we played like, it was baseball without a bat, if you want to say that. So, go ahead, brother.
Who was your favorite teacher?
Miss Valentina. She was a funny Italian, and she talked about good food. So, anyone else?
Do you have standardized testing?
Yes, standardized testing. That is true. You know, I even took typing here. You guys have typing here? Man, that was like the best, because, you know, when you play video games, the one finger just doesn't work. So, but yeah, no, typing was huge. But yeah, the standardized test. Anyone else?
What was your favorite grade?
Favorite grade? Oh, well, obviously, eighth grade. I came here, I was here 5 years. So I came from the west side of Chicago, bus here. And then I was here for 5 years, and my brother was here for 5 years. But yeah, eighth grade is the turning point, you know, of my life.
How diverse did you see the schools?
It was not as diverse. I mean, there was a time that there was a neighborhood gang had like attacked some kids in school, and it wasn't as diverse, so it was a bit of a challenge. It's not as flavorful as it is today, which is actually awesome. Go ahead.
Did being at Thorpe have a big impact on your life?
I'm sorry?
Did being at Thorpe have a big impact on our life?
Yeah, it was huge, because coming from the west side, there wasn't a lot of different ethnicities. And so we were a little bit challenged that way. So just to be in this element and able to see different people, it helped us immensely, because where we were growing up, we were receiving a little bit of a lie. And so it's so good to be in a place where everybody's different, because then we get our own mind about life and about people. You know, because, you know, what you hear about someone, or if you see television or the news and they always talk negatively about somebody, then all of a sudden you think that every person is the way. Or like every, you know, sometimes people who don't know any better put us in categories. So just for instance, everyone thinks someone Spanish is Mexican, and that's not true. There's different flavors of Latinos. But people assume that because they don't know, because they never lived or know people that are different. Just like, you know, people from different places, like, you know, Romania or or, you know, Poland or